The Philippine Education Department under fire from activists and party-list groups for suspending the operations of 55 lumad schools in the Davao region. Education officials ordered the suspension over accusations by National Security Advisor Hermoenes Esperon that the schools were teaching what he calls left-leaning ideologies. But the Bayan Muna party list describes that order as unjust and a denial of lumad children's right to education. We now have on the line Education Secretary Leonor Briones. Madam Secretary, thank you for joining us. Thanks for talking to us this noon and welcome to the program.
Thank you, Carmina. I trust you to give the side of the DepEd and pass it on to our listeners and viewers.
So let's talk about that now, Madam Secretary.
Yes, yes.
I just read the news that it was based on National Security Advisor Hermoenes Esperon's order or pronouncement, and that was what led you to suspend the operations. Tell us, what was the tipping point for you that made you give the order to suspend the operations of these 55 lumad schools?
You know, Carmela, this issue has been going on for the past 3 years, as you are well aware of. Last year, these 55 Salupungan schools did not receive their permit to operate because every year the permit to operate has to be renewed. And there were requirements of the Department of Education which they did not comply with. We have been having dialogues and dialogues. Out of the 55, Carmina, 11 are the ones, there are only 11 who are applying for permit this year. The others have stopped because they have closed their schools due to lack of students. Also, during the past 3 years, the Department of Education has built schools in the very same areas where these Salupungan schools are, because these are all public schools. And we gave also during the past administration 500 million out of that budget to build schools for the indigenous peoples in these three areas. By the way, Carmina, in the entire country, you have 2.6 million indigenous learners in our various schools. This is about 11% of total enrollment. We have 33,633 schools, which have 74% of all the schools, which is 74% of all the schools in the country, which have indigenous children, ranging all over the country, from the north, which I have visited, to the south. Mm. The issue that has been raised concerns three groups of schools only in three provinces. Out of the 55, it's only 11 who are applying for permits. So we have been having dialogues since I assumed office, because it is the regional office which issues permits to operate. Last year, none of the 55 were issued permits to operate because they did not comply with the requirements for any school for that matter, Carmina, whether public, Catholic, Protestant, etc., to operate. Mm-hmm. So we are talking here only of 11 schools which are now applying for permits.
Secretary
and
Briones.
Last February.
Yeah,
yes,
Secretary Briones, let me just get this question in. Whatever the number is, you know what the left has been saying. How should this not be seen as collateral damage in the government's crackdown on communists?
Well, we have our own regulations. And we have been issuing permits to many private schools as long as they comply with our regulations. For example, Carmina, they should have a permanent place where they have classes. They should have teachers. They should have a school director. And also the curriculum has to comply with our requirements. And so many schools, not only the so-called lumad schools, were not able to comply. And if they are not able to comply, they don't get permits. So since last year, they were not legally existing because these 55 schools don't have permits. Many of them don't have students anymore. because there are alternative schools. Now, if a school is not issued a permit to operate, then it is not in our master list of students and schools. And the students cannot transfer. For example, if they want to proceed to college, if they want to transfer to another high school, they cannot do so because they don't have a learner's record. Mm-hmm. And in addition also, the memorandum of Secretary Esperon was dated February. But before, we have been receiving complaints from various groups, even from local government, and also from the Peace and Order Council of Davao City, signed by all the members asking us to close the schools. But we want to follow due process. We cannot close, Carmina, what does not legally exist and what has not been legally existing since last year. Nevertheless, we are doing this to verify the claims, the observations, not only of Secretary Esperon, a very senior person in the government, but also of local government, lumad groups, and so on.
Okay, Madam
this
Secretary.
Involves three schools out of 33,000 schools and 2.6 million children who are of IP, who belong to the IP communities.
Madam Secretary, let's wrap this up with this last question. With what is happening right now, what do you think is more probable? That these schools reopen or that these schools are permanently shut down?
The procedure is, Carmina, the procedure is it is the regional director who issues the permit. And so in the light of the complaint filed by Secretary Esperon, we ask the regional director to look into the points that the secretary has brought up. But as far as we are concerned, these 55 schools have not had any permit to operate since last year because they were not issued. Now, there are 11 out of the 55 who are now applying for permits. And we have also this resolution from the Davao City Council also requesting us not to give permits for various reasons. But for us also, in addition to the request of Secretary Esperon, we have our own requirements. For example, the curriculum. For example, the number of teachers. For example, a permanent place, title, a building, and perhaps a director. Each school has to have a director for the school. And we are requiring this of all schools.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And so we have to take to look at the bigger picture. Now, you're asking me what will probably happen.
Yes.
It is the regional director which will decide because several administrations ago, the authority to give permits to operate have already been decentralized down to the regional directors. This is why we ask them to look into the proposals of Secretary Esperon. But as far as we are concerned, they don't have any permits since last year. And there are 11 applying, of which there are objections to their application.
Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.